Alright, hello everybody, this is Inferno 11. Welcome back to Warframe, Dark Souls 2, yeah. So, in the last episode, we killed the old Iron King, and I think the easiest fight with him I have ever done or seen. In this episode, we are going to be continuing on our quest of collecting the four ancient souls that we need. In particular, we need to actually go, remember that guy, Benhart, I guess, that we helped by clearing the path? That is actually where we need to go next, is back to this this bonfire. Because we actually have two bosses to go. Also, fire arrows are extremely helpful. Make sure you also have a fragrant branch of yore. They are very, very, very helpful. Oh, shoot. Actually, you know what? I've got to go do something really quick in the game. I forgot to go use that one key to unlock the door for the guy, so I will be right back. This is what I was talking about. I forgot to come back to Huntsman's Copse to unlock this key that we got from killing that invasion. A, we get a bonfire, but B, we get to talk to this guy.
I thought you were that bastard. You've sent me the cheeky...
That bastard. The cheeky...
Person. I am Crichton of Mira.
Of Mira. Ah, this isn't the first time we've heard of Mira. Perhaps this is Lucatiel's brother.
I've heard this land was full of danger. I joined forces with a man on the way. He took the first chance he had. I decided to set a trap for him here. I can't believe that. You be careful of him.
Pate. So perhaps Pate is the one.
You know,
that...
I've seen his type before. I'm sure I won't be his last victim. He's a slick to...
So Pate was the guy that was
Pate.
Evil.
And
so we talked to him, and we will basically, not to spoil the quest, but later on we'll be able to choose between the two who we want to help. Typically because Pate already gave me his full set of armor, I'd side with Crichton, because Crichton will then give you his armor. But it's up to you what you want to do. Okay, so I'm going to head back to here and actually continue with what we were doing. Oh, this area sucks, too. Like, it's bad. Fire arrows are very helpful for what's coming up. You have to fight a bunch of spiders. And the spiders, while they are not very hard to beat, they are not pleasant. Oh, do I have to lift the gate? Huh. Oh, yeah, you must. Whatever. Oh, they come out of here, too? See, I bought like 200 arrows and I'm already using them. Get headshots on them. Headshots deal more damage. It's taking forever. I believe he is actually a... That was actually a gear. I know it was a gear. So we continue on. You can write messages and leave them for other players, so like if you find a trap, you can warn them, yada yada. Yes. These guys aren't particularly dangerous. It does help that I have pretty good armor and a really good weapon. You want to be careful because they throw rocks, and the rocks actually do pretty good damage. That's the main reason why I love the greatsword. Like you saw right there, I was actually able to just... You basically have an almost 360 degree attack radius with the... Get another Pharaoh's Longstone. With the the greatsword, which is just so helpful if you're being surrounded or if you think you're going to fight a lot of opponents. It's great. So they were eating at night, basically. Okay. Now what you want to do... drink Estus Flask because... there's a bonfire right here. I don't know why I drank the Estus Flask. I just rested the bonfire. Okay, now you have three potential ways you could go. You can go this way, which... this leads to Drangelic Castle. Because we do not have the four ancient souls yet, we cannot go this way. We could go this way, which leads to a hidden area. I don't remember what this leads to, but this does lead to something. Oh, those poison. I do not want to fight those. Or those petrify, sorry. Poison. And then there is this way, the Silence Witch, which leads to one of the four ancient souls that we need. Now, the shitty thing about this area is that there are invisible enemies. Now, do you see that right there, that white outline? They cannot be seen, or they have that white outline. You might be able to see them, but do you see how it just got really white? You can't see them in that. You can, but barely. They also will backstab you a lot. Actually, you know what? Just in case. Normally, I can get through here without being attacked, but I'm going to equip the Jester set just in case. So if I do get backstabbed, they can't get a critical. If you are careful, you can get through here without being attacked. Because there is somebody we want to talk to that'll help us get ahead in the game. So we need to... I'm going to try to not trigger an attack. Now, you can progress through here decently. I would not recommend going into the woods themselves because there are those assholes that will just charge you. But more importantly, if we circle around to here, we get a fire seed. And if we go to here, there's a head.
Leave me be. I like it. What bit you make up, tis rare. Long ago, I remember a game too. I don't know what now I watch the day. I'd grown weary of battle. I know not what you may bear a great, but I see vision. My body,
so he is warning us that his body, without his head, is still alive, and it is very dangerous. So here he is saying he will give us support. So here we can buy a claymore, which is a two-handed weapon, and we can buy a greatsword. So if you didn't pick up the greatsword, you can buy it here. You can also buy lightning items, which are very helpful.
I cannot.
But we want to keep talking to him, because he is actually gives us something.
I am great, but so why? Thank you for here.
And he gives us his helm.
Farewell.
So if we come back here and talk to him after we kill his body, which we are going to do, he will give us a reward. Now you can go through here and kill them. I'm not going to. There are items in here that are decent, but there is a DLC item that actually allows you to see the invisible. That includes these guys. Also, you can't lock onto the ghosts, or whatever they are. So trying to fight them without a wide attack weapon, like the greatsword, is very difficult. But it is still not a fight I relish, nor is it a fight I enjoy, especially because I have to fight them anyways. Okay, I made it. Also, do you see this face in the tree? If you go near the faces out there, what will happen is they will scream and attract the ghosts to try to kill you. Yes, I do. I have two. And actually, I have to take another quick break because I have to go back to Marjula to get something called the Ring of Whispers for an ally for this upcoming fight, because this fight is a pain in the ass. So, I will see you guys when I get back. Alright, and we are back. So, the Ring of Whispers costs 5,800 souls, so if you want to make sure you have that amount before you go back, that's what you need. This area is quite bad, like I've said before. For example, these are the ghosts that are in the woods. One As you can see, they've got a good amount of health. 1,081, so if you don't have a really heavy-hitting weapon, it's going to take you a while to kill them. And even worse, each successive attack is going to be harder and harder and harder to beat. Let's see. There is actually something we want to do, but I'm not going to do that right now. Actually, I should do that right now before I progress any further, so I can just warp back. Now, normally you have to go through, you have to use a few stones, or a few of the branches to get through here. And you want to save them. But if you do a running jump, you can actually get over that one. And you can kill that moth before it poisons you. You want to come up here, actually. And here we have another Sylvan Knight. And as you can see now, we are actually using his shield. We wear it then. So if we do that, we get the Soul of a Brave Warrior, which is a pretty good one. And we get Sublime Bone Dust, which will upgrade our Estus Flask, which is pretty good. Or it upgrades how much it heals. I'm gonna grab the Twilight Herb. Now, I could use this branch on this guy. However, I need both branches. But we want to do a running jump over into here. Just to be sure. Because there are not very many mimics that are steel chests. They're mostly wood, but there are some. So we get the Black Knight Halberd. The Black Knight Halberds are, I think they have a base fire damage always. But I'm going to, instead of wasting my Fragrant Branch of Yore to do this, I'm going to just escape. And warp. And what this will do is it'll warp me back to the last place I did. Or the last place that I saved at, which was here. So, I just have to kill this guy again. Hi-ya! Oh, so he doesn't require the full arm to kill him. That's just how much I did. Now, this area has a gimmick, which is you can be cursed. If you are cursed, you lose your humanity, and each successive curse will steadily reduce your health. I hate the dark. I hate Forlorn. No, please have your greatsword. Thank goodness. I've never got him to actually drop his weapon. Letting me just wail on you. Oh, please try to heal. Done and done. Moving right along. I was saying, each successive curse will reduce your total health, which kind of sucks. But we have iron arrows, so we can break them. That curse you. Now we actually want to run to right here because not only is this the one poisoning us, but there's one up there. Pop that one and we're good. Now unfortunately, if we come down to here, we have a spirit. That spirit is no match for me. Brave Warrior Soul, and we get a Pharaoh's Lockstone. Now we come in here, and there's actually going to be a crystal lizard right there. We kill him, and we get a shard, two shards, a chunk, and a bolt stone. So that's good for if you use a lightning. Boot, do a running jump up to the ledge. We do another one, and there we see a, oh my gosh, it's a giant scorpion man. And we get a dark scythe. So basically it does extra hex damage. feel bad. My, the orange cat, I was playing with him, and normally he's really good when he plays. Like, he matches your intensity of play with his. But today he decided to just be an asshole, and we were playing, and I was doing something that normally is considered a step up, in terms of play. Like, I was tickling him, and then I stopped, and then he, and then I pretended to bite, like, my hand was biting him a little bit, and he actually dug in pretty deep, and he gave me a good inch and a half, slash across my wrist, which hurt. But what you want to do here, and this is why this is actually important, you want to equip the Ring of Whispers. This will actually tell you if you've killed every enemy in an area, because most enemies will roar, but it lets you talk
human.
To him.
Oh, this is no place. Are you not human? Those who... But you? We once had a master, but he was born with a face. He resented those who had what he lacked and became... Eventually, it was at the peak of this mad... Our master was a tragically lonely... Eventually, his solid... In the end, he... What it was that he... Nobody knows when we... Or where I'm... The only ones who even speak a human tongue are myself and my better half. I always found her at my side. She became violent. Eventually, she... We have been locked in com... We seem to be... I will be sure. The path... My name...
So, here he tells us his name is Tark, and now he will assist us when we fight the boss of this area. The Ring of Thorns, no... I think... Oh, that's right, I was using the Chloranthony Ring, but my Chloranthony is pretty good right now. I think I'm gonna use the Life Ring. I'll just deal with the reduced regen. But if we go down here, we see another Fragrant Branch of Yore. This is one of the ones I want to use this on. Because, remember the guys, the head? These guys hit for so much. And they do curse damage. Lots of it. Bad too. Now, remember the curse, or the guy that who said his body was on a rampage? Well, his body is right here. This is Vengarl's body. He uses two swords. He hits pretty hard. He has a lot of health. If you're gonna fight him, just try to be careful. I've got pretty high endurance and pretty high poise, so he's not going to be able to break my shield very easily. Not everybody is going to be built as like my character is, though, so be careful. But we can take him out and we get his armor set, which is actually very good. Now the downside is we didn't get another Fragrant Branch of Yore. We are down one. That is okay, though, because we actually got something just as good. So now what we need to do is if we go talk to Vengarl again, he will actually randomly help us in certain places, like against the end boss, or the boss of the game. He will actually assist you. So we need to leave here. But there's a couple of places where you can get an additional Fragrant Branch of Yore, which I'm going to try to get. Another one is over there, but I don't think you actually get a Fragrant Branch for that, so I'm not going to go over there. I don't think you get anything good over there, so I'm not going to go over there. I'm not going to do that. This one is a bit of a pain, so... Kill you. I don't think I have to worry about them. It pays to every once in a while do a 360, though, just to make sure. Yeah, there's another shade right there. Basilisk. And we want to use our last fragrant branch of yore on this guy. Oh shit, please don't. Damn it. Well, I might as well just stay cursed for right now. We kill him, he managed to drop one of his legs. But more importantly, we open this chest, and we get another fragrant branch of yore. That's why doing this one is okay. And we get the full client set. Okay. So, now what we need to do is we need to actually run up here. Because it's Creighton.
Don't you scare me like that. That bastard with a ring.
It's in Brightstone Cove, so you have to make sure to talk to both of these guys twice. So do talk to them every chance you can before you go to Brightstone, which is Brightstone Cove is where we get the last ancient soul that we need. Because if you don't, you lose out on this quest and you can't complete it. So now we got another one. So what we need to do now is we actually need to. Oh no, we fell down a hole. How bad? Now, I'm not a hexer, so I'm not particularly worried about this, but this is a good area. A good thing to do. If we talk to this guy three times, we will be able to go into the void, or the dark, or the abyss. And that will allow us to do stuff. Now, as much as you may want to do that, you actually don't. You want to come out here. There's an item over here that I forgot about. Might as well. Okay. Now you want to use this fragrant branch of yore on this guy. When he comes back to life, he will give you, when he dies. Kill him. I saved you from being stoned. He gives you the Fang Key. This is needed to unlock an NPC later on who is actually quite important. But also, the NPC then you pick up another fragrant branch of yours, so don't ever lose one doing it this way. Okay, I'm not worried about that item, whatever it is. Okay, now we want to go down here again. Now, be careful stepping into that. That's acid. It doesn't actually hurt you, but it degrades your equipment at a ridiculously high pace. Or rate. Overall bad. So we kill those two. So go in here and pick up the Twinkling Titanite. And then unlock the door using the Fang Key that we just got. There we have Orthix. I don't know what her name is.
Thank you for helping. I am Ornifex.
Ornifex.
I owe you something. If it wouldn't.
She lives, or it lives, in Brightstone Cove, and she will turn boss souls into weapons, some of them. And she will do sometimes different weapons than Strayed will. So those are the two people that you can do it with. I'm not going to kill her because I actually need her, and I don't like killing just random NPCs. But, so we go back here, and now we make the very long trek. Back up. Oh, also the smelter demon is actually worth fighting, because if you kill him, the guy that sells you armor, I don't remember what his name is, he will actually give you, or you can buy, the Smelter Demon's armor set. And it's actually extremely high defense, and it also has insanely good, like, it is the single best fire-resistant armor in the game. Might as well. And I'm going to summon Man Scorpion Tark. Preparation for this as well. Yeah, There we go. Okay. Greetings aside, let's do this. And so here, we see there is a girl sunk up to her waist. She uses sorceries a lot. But we see she is actually a scorpion. But with focus on her tails. Now, she does a lot of physical, like, she has a good wide range of attacks. Her tails also deal not just poison, but they deal toxic damage. Toxic damage is horrible. It does very high poison damage, and it's good. That's fun. You can trick her into knocking down that tree to get that item, but I remember it distinctly being a complete waste of time. Don't bother. Also, running through here, you are going to find messages saying hidden or mirage all over the place. There are no secrets in this area. Don't bother looking. Or in this stretch of corridor, so don't bother. Okay, so we come into here. Oh yeah, if it's an illusionary wall, funny I can't break it. Interesting concept. Okay. Here we have a mammoth warrior. Mammoth warriors... They're mammoths, and they do a lot of motion. They hit for a lot of damage. And they have a lot of health. And an armor. Just, if you're a mage, keep your distance and just blast him. He's super easy. If you don't, use poison. Mastodon, that's what he is. I'm gonna trick this asshole to come get me. Get me. Interestingly enough, their shields are basically pure stone, and you can actually use them to, they have the best fire resistance out of the acid shields, unless you use the rebel shield. So we activate the bonfire, and that is that. So this episode, we took out the Scorpioness. Now, if we go and talk to, Tark again, he will give us a ring, but I'm going to wait to go do that because he gives us a better ring if we kill the boss of this, the actual, like, third Ancient Soul first. So I'll see you guys in the next episode.